Well, guys, today is the day. We are getting set pictures revealed for the rest of 2020. Not the rest of 2020, mostly summer 2020, but most of the sets that are going to come out in 2020. The pictures are revealed. And I'm going to go over them. I will throw up the pictures on the screen. I know my mock is here. You can go check out that video if you want, but it's just here just because why not? I don't know. I don't have anything else to show in the background right now. So I guess we'll get started. So we will start with the Razor Crest, or the Knights of Ren transport ship. This ship, I think the ship looks pretty good. The concept image by BrickWizard59, I think looks substantially better, but I'm sure it uses a lot more pieces, so it'd be hard to look for Lego to make something like that. But I think the ship looks pretty good. It comes with Rey, who I think I already have Rey down here somewhere. I can't find her. Oh, there she is. I'll remove the image real quick. I think that's the Rey from what it looks like. This is the exact Rey we're getting from the Pasonic Speeder Chase. And then we get the rest of the Knights of Ren. We get the last two. Fortunately, we only get three minifigures. It'd be nice if we got like a Poe or a BB-8 or a Chewbacca or something. But we only got three, and I guess that's what it is. I think this set's going to cost $70, if I remember correctly. And unfortunately for me, I don't think this is one that I'm going to be able to pick up, especially because of like the limited budget that I can spend on Lego sets. So sadly, I may not be able to get my hands on this one. So next, we move on to the ITS Transporter. Is that what it's called? It's the Galaxy's Edge ship. And this one is the same. It's probably one I'm not going to be able to pick up. Because with the limited budget that I have, I'm trying to pick up sets that I want. And like the 501st set and the AAT are going to be sets I'm going to pick up. Same with the General Grievous Starfighter and mostly like Clone Wars stuff I'm gonna grab off the shelves, that's for sure. But anyways, we'll just go over this set and what I think of it. This set is, it's an interesting one. It's one that isn't really in the Star Wars universe except for by Galaxy's Edge. I mean, does it being at Galaxy's Edge make it canon? I don't know, but I guess the ship itself is actually pretty nice. I actually like the design of the ship. I think it looks pretty cool. We get four minifigures, technically three because one's brick built. We get some girl, I don't know her name, some like Admiral Akbar looking guy who's has a gray face, which I don't know his name. We have a Gonk droid, and we have an Astromech, like a black one. The girl, I don't know if that's a new hairpiece, but if it is, that's probably going to be a valuable hairpiece and one that a lot of people are going to want to have. The Admiral Akbar looking guy, the Mon Calamari guy, I think that's a new headpiece because it's gray, so that's actually kind of cool. The Gonk droid is kind of standard. I don't really think it's that great. And then the Astromech, I think it's different, so I guess it's kind of like exclusive. So we'll move on to the next one. Now we have the Advent Calendar. And this is, I'm probably gonna get this Advent Calendar, if I'm gonna be honest. Especially since it'll be later in the year, like around like early December, when everyone would be picking up this Advent Calendar. I'd probably have some money saved up by then, so I'd probably be able to get it. So this is probably one that I'm gonna get. And it's one that, for me, would be well worth it. You get a Sith Trooper, you get a Stormtrooper, you get Rey, which we already have, I already have. You get Farm Boy Luke. I only have two Lukes, and one's the really old one, and one's the like 2016 Advent Calendar one that's like the Death Star Final Duel one. Anyways, I don't have a Farm Boy Luke, or a new one. You get a Pit Droid, you get a, I don't have a Pit Droid, you get a Porg. I don't have a Porg either. You get a Battle Droid, which Battle Droids are nice to have. And then you get a Poe Dameron in a sweatshirt, which is kind of an interesting looking one. Same with Darth Vader, he's an interesting looking sweatshirt. You get Dio, who I don't have either. And then you get a mini X-Wing, which actually looks kind of good. You get, I think that's Luke's hut. I don't know for sure. That one looks pretty good as well. Same with an A-Wing. That is an A-Wing design they should have used on the May the 4th promo. I didn't get that promo, but from what I've seen, the A-Wing looks really bad, and this A-Wing is one that is what they should have put in. Then we get what looks to be the Final Order TIE Fighter, if I'm correct. It doesn't have any red on it, so I can't really tell. And then there's a Razor Crest, which that looks pretty good. And then there's a Millennium Falcon, which that's actually a really, really slim, good-looking version of that. We get a Snow Speeder, that looks decent, in my opinion. We get Darth Vader's castle with a mini, like, Darth Vader's TIE Fighter. That's actually kind of interesting to me. That Darth Vader's TIE Fighter, never would have thought about that building technique. It's very interesting. And the Darth Vader's castle is pretty nice, too. And then we get a CIS command station, one of those big space stations with, like, the ring look. That is very, very interesting that they finally made this. They haven't made it in any other form. I don't think it's, like, a mini in an advent calendar any other time. I think this is the first time they've made this. So that's pretty, pretty interesting. It looks all right, but I'm sure it's kind of hard to make. Then, what is that, a Tauntaun? I think it's Tauntaun. I don't really know for sure, but it looks kind of interesting. Especially with the redstone on the front. I don't really know why they did that. They could have just put, like, some random printed piece or something. I don't know. Then there's some, like, Christmas Gonk Droid, which, that's alright. I mean, not bad. And that looks to be it from this advent calendar. So yeah, like I said, I'll probably be picking this one up. Next we have the remake of the Death Star Final Duel. We have the Darth Vader with the printed arms, which, I mean, that's pretty good. I mean, printed arms on a Darth Vader I don't think that's happened yet, so that's gonna be the draw to this set, is the printed arms on Darth Vader. The Luke, I don't really think that anything's changed. I have an Episode 6 Luke, and they don't look too different. There's two guards, which I don't have any of those red guards, I just have the shadow ones. And then Emperor Palpatine, which I don't have him either, so he'd be cool. And this is one that, if I have enough money, I'm gonna get this. If I'm gonna be honest with you, I have money to where I could buy all these sets, but it's my parents and allowing me to buy them. Yes, that sounds puny, and yes, I know it is. It's not something I agree with, but I kind of get it, but I have enough money. I don't know. But this is one that I'd want to pick up because I didn't get the one from, I don't remember what year, but the first one. I didn't get that one, and I don't have three of these minifigures. I don't have a Darth Vader. I only have the 20th anniversary one, but I don't have an actual, like, regular Darth Vader minifigure. I don't have an Emperor Palpatine, and I don't have a red royal guard. I have the Luke. The rest I don't have. And the set, it looks pretty good, in my opinion. I think the set looks very good. So this is one that I'm hopefully going to pick up. So next we'll move to the Anakin's Jedi Interceptor. This one, I don't have the old one, so I can't, like, compare it and say, like, oh, this is a ripoff. Why did we get a remake of this? But this is one that I actually might pick up because I don't have an Anakin's Jedi Interceptor. I don't even have the Clone Wars one. So this would be one that I'm probably going to pick up. The Anakin is new because of the face. I think the rest of the stuff's the same. There's an R2-D2, and I don't have an R2-D2 with a silver head. I have older R2-D2s. So that's a nice R2-D2 to get, and a nice new Anakin. And the ship itself looks pretty good, so this is probably one I'm going to pick up, and I have no complaints about, especially because I don't have the other one. And this doesn't, like, feel like a wasted space to me. Next, we have the Razor Crest. This thing, I think, is sold out of LEGO.com and probably Amazon. And this is one that I don't think I'm going to be able to get because it's not one that's on the top of my list of wants. I mean, I might be able to persuade my mom because of Baby Yoda. That might be the only way to get this set for me. But I would want this set. This is a set that I would pick. I'd pick up all of them if I could. But this is one that is probably in the middle of my list of wanting to get. I don't have the Mandalorian because I don't have the AT-ST. I don't have any newer Scout Troopers. I don't have any newer IG units. And obviously no one has Greef Karga. I think that's his name. No one has him because he's not a minifigure yet until now. And who doesn't want Baby Yoda? And the ship itself is actually pretty good. I think the ship looks very good. So this is one that I'd want to get, but One, it's pretty expensive, not for what it is, but just for like how much money I have. And two, I don't know, it's kind of in the middle of my list and not like on the top of my wants, but it is a really good set. Next, we move to the AT-AT. This is one that I don't have any of the previous versions of. I don't have any AT-ATs. I have the ATM-6, but I don't have any AT-ATs. And this set actually looks really, really good. I think it's $160, so it's out of my price range as well, but it looks very good. You get two Snowtroopers, which I have one from the 2016 Advent Calendar, and Snowtroopers look pretty cool. They kind of remind me of Galactic Marines, so I do like those guys. You get two of the AT-AT pilots, which I don't have any of those guys. You get General Veers, is that his name? I forget, he's the guy that's in the cockpit of the AT-AT. And I definitely don't have him because I don't have any AT-ATs. And then you get Luke, in which I don't have like one of the newer pilot Lukes. I have the really old one, but I don't have any of the newer ones. So this is the AT-AT itself looks very, very good. And it's one that I would want to get. But like I said, it's out of my price range. And I think this thing looks 20 million times better than the previous ones. It looks way bigger and more bulky. And it looks like it was actually like built by someone who knows what they were doing. It doesn't look like it has any holes or any gaps or anything like that. I think it looks good. So next we'll move on to General Grievous's Starfighter. Now this is one that's controversial because there's no Phase 2 Cody. They did the same Obi-Wan. I'll grab him right now. I have him right here. This is the Obi-Wan. It's the same one from the Duan Mustafar. Same Obi-Wan. And General Grievous does not change. And then the ship is kind of basic. Kind of like the one in 2013? I don't know. I don't remember when they made the ship last. But a lot of people don't like this. And it's a controversial set. And I get why. But I don't have an Airborne Trooper. I really want an Airborne Trooper. And they're pretty expensive. And it's not one that I can just go out and buy. Because my mother would not let me. I don't have General Grievous' Starfighter. Obi-Wan, okay, I can get past that. And same with General Grievous. I just really want the Airborne Trooper. This is one that I was going to buy no matter what clone came in it, because I don't have any 212 clones except my 80 figures one. And I don't have General Grievous' Starfighter. So this is one that I am going to pick up, even with the price that it's at. So next we'll move, wait. I didn't go over the ship and how it looks yet. It looks like General Grievous' Starfighter. It looks like how it's supposed to be. I think it looks pretty good, looks pretty sleek. So it's not a bad model. That's not what it is. It's just the piece count and the figures and how they copied over Obi-Wan. And that's one thing I think, like, I agree with a lot of other people that LEGO was kind of lazy on that. I don't know why they copied that Obi-Wan over. I really don't know why. That he was not on Mustafar before he went to Utapau. That makes no sense. The clones would have already committed Order 66. I'm going off topic. But anyways, yeah, it doesn't make any sense. But it's something we all will get through when we buy the set. Anyone who will buy the set. Next, we move on to the 501st Legion Clone Troopers, or the 501st Battle Pack. In my opinion, this would be called like an Ultimate Battle Pack because it has 6 minifigures. So, I mean, that's what I would call it. And I mean, I don't know. But anyways, we get 3 regular 501st clones. We get a 501st Jet Trooper, 2 droids, a speeder, and an AT-RT. Now, the 501st clones look very good in my opinion. I think these clones have been like modeled very well. I think the printing on them is stellar. I mean, a lot of people don't like that they don't have black hips and they don't have blue arms. Well, I don't really care. I mean, to me, they kind of look like they're wearing like pajamas or they're wearing like a onesie because they don't have any like separation between any of their kind of like body parts. Like the belt isn't very, you can't really tell that the belt is there separating the legs from the torso. if that makes any sense. I still think they look fine though, and people are all up in arms about how they don't have blue arms. They should have blue arms. I don't think they should have blue arms. I don't, because if you look at a 501st Trooper, their arms are not primarily blue. They're mostly white. It's only basically the shoulder pad and maybe a stripe on the arm. That's it. There's not really that much blue on the arm. So I think the arms are fine being white. The Jet Trooper looks very good. I like how they have a blue jetpack. So that's really it for that guy. I think he's got very good printing and he'd be a pretty cool figure, in my opinion. I think these guys would look really cool in person. They look one way in the pictures, but I think they would look even better in person. Next, we have the Battle Droids. The Battle Droids are Battle Droids, so don't really have to go over them. The Speeder is pretty good, refined Speeder. I think that Speeder, even with the Stud Shooters on it, looks fine, in my opinion. I mean, it would be nice not to have the Stud Shooters, but what can you do? LEGO's trying to implement play features for kids, and in that regard, I think they're in a fine spot for kids to grab the Speeder and press the Stud Shooter shooting mechanism while they're playing with it, and it works well. I think that one would work well, and I think it's a really good looking Speeder. Next, we have the AT-RT, which everything but the front gun looks good on this AT-RT. It is oversized, but they're kind of just trying to get to that piece count. The gun is horrible. It's horrible. It's kind of embarrassing how bad it is. It's just a Stud Shooter. The barrel is obviously longer than that in universe. I mean, we all could just go and replace these with regular turrets or guns or whatever, but I don't know. It looks bad. One thing I'm gonna cover and finish with this set is the new gun. I don't know if it's a new gun or if it's just a piece they added, but I think it looks pretty good. I think it looks kind of like it would be a Flametrooper's gun, but it also kind of looks like it might be like a DC-15. So I think the gun actually looks pretty good, this new one with the added barrel. I don't know if it's in the picture I'm going to throw up, but maybe we'll see. I don't know. You'll see. Next, we'll move on to the AAT, the final set that we'll be talking about here. This set goes back and proves what I was saying before we knew what the set was, before the pictures were announced, when I made my Droid Army video. That Droid Army video came out before those leaked images. It was made before those leaked images came out. I hadn't posted until after those leaked images came out of these sets, but it was made before then. So I didn't know that they were going to throw these AAT pilots in here, these pilot droids, and actually call them the right name. I didn't know that, and I knew already that these guys were pilot droids. Gunners or pilot droids. That's what they are. And, like, we got it right. They didn't call them Kashyyyk battle droids. They're not Kashyyyk battle droids. If you look at the Battle of Kashyyyk, droids don't have those markings. So, we're gonna get off the kind of, like, rant about how I was right about that, which I don't want to go too far on that. I was right, but we'll just end it off there. And check out my Droid Army video. It's not that big, but it's still important to me to show my Droid Army to people on YouTube. So anyways, we'll move on to the rest of the figures. We have Ahsoka. Ahsoka, I don't have an Ahsoka yet, and this Ahsoka looks very good in my opinion. I would say the Bagels For Real one. Definitely check him out on Instagram. I don't remember if he has a YouTube channel or not, but definitely on Instagram, go check him out. He's got really, really good customs. His definitely looks better, but I get it. LEGO can't spend a ton of money trying to make a perfect-looking figure. So I think the Ahsoka looks very good. It'll be a fine addition to my collection. And yeah, that's what I have to say about her. Then we move on to basically the staple of this set, the box art figure, the 3/32 Clone Trooper. This guy, I'm so happy LEGO made this guy. I'm so happy they didn't just leave it up to the custom Clone Trooper makers, like Clone Army Customs and AV Figures. Don't get me wrong, those guys are really good and they're really good at making good figures, but I'm happy LEGO made one because LEGO is the company that everyone goes off of. And they made a 3 30-second clone. That's very good. I mean, a lot of people are gonna probably pick up multiple of this set, in which I'm sadly only gonna be pick up one, so I'll have only one 3 30-second clone unless I like buy a couple more in Brooklyn or something. But who knows how much these guys are gonna cost? I mean, it might cost $10, like median average for these clones. You never know. You really never know, but I think those guys look really good, and I'm definitely going to be picking up this set. This is a set that I'm no doubt going to be picking up. I forgot to tell you about how many sets I'm going to be picking up for the 501st Battle Pack, or the 501st Legion Clone Troopers, as it's really called. That set, at first, I'll pick up two. What I want to do is I kind of want to do it in, like, sections. I'm going to pick up, or I'm going to buy, like, a certain, like, amount of sets at first, and then do a second buy and buy a couple more. Or maybe just like go to Target and pick up a couple there. So I'm kind of changing my strategy. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna, on Amazon, when these sets come out, I'm gonna buy the AAT, General Grievous as Starfighter, two 501st Battle Packs, and maybe the Anakin Jedi Interceptor. And then if like I go to Target or Walmart or whatever store that has Lego sets, I'm gonna buy a 501st Battle Pack whenever I go, because I'm gonna try and buy as many as I can, because my parents never really like got me into army building, and I never like was really into the battle pack army building stuff. So I kind of, yeah, that wasn't really my thing. I don't have multiple of the set because I bought them, just because like my cousin gave me another battle pack, so I have duplicates of it, like the Elite Clone Troopers battle pack. But anyways, this is a set that I finally want to buy multiples of, because I want to buy multiples of, not just because a multiple is given to me. So that's really going to wrap it up for this video. This is a pretty long video. I don't know if anyone's going to stick around, but it's all about my opinion. I feel like that's what most people are here to listen to, is to see the sets and to see them in another video and to see how someone else's point of view is on these sets. So I want to thank you all who made it to this point for watching this video. Please like, comment, and subscribe to this video. Subscribe to my channel if you're new, and comment down below what you think of these sets and what you think of like my strategy of what sets I'm buying, because these are the sets that I want that I'm buying first, like the AAT, the 501st Battle Pack, the Forgetting Sets, look, General Grievous as Starfighter. Those sets, those are the ones that I want, like, really bad, so I'm buying those first. Just comment down below on, like, that kind of strategy stuff. And like the video if you like how I opinionize myself on these sets. So I want to thank you all for watching, and I will see you in another video.